Hi there, and thanks for checking out this video. I'm John from Tennis Companion, and today we're talking about tennis string gauge. String gauge refers to the thickness or the diameter of a tennis string, with available sizes ranging from 13 to 22. Although many people find it counterintuitive, the lower the gauge, the thicker the string, while the higher the gauge, the thinner the string. Typically, you'll find the gauge of a string printed prominently on the package. Note the specific measurement of the string's thickness in millimeters as well. Each gauge represents a range of measurement. For example, one of the most popular string gauges is 16, which represents any string between 1.26 and 1.34 millimeters thick. Here's a table of some of the most popular string gauges for reference. As you review the chart, there are two observations worth noting. First, 15 and 16 gauge strings come in light or slightly thinner versions as denoted by 15L and 16L. Second, there's some overlap between gauge measurements, so there are cases where manufacturers can pick the gauge for marketing their strings. Luckily, string gauges have become more standardized. For example, it's common to find a 16-gauge string to be 1.3 millimeters thick. However, there is still some variation that exists. Here are a few example strings where the gauge is the same, but the thickness in millimeters is different. For that reason, along with the overlap that can exist between measurements for gauges, I prefer to reference the thickness of a string in millimeters, which you're almost always find printed on the package as well. In fact, in some cases, that's all you'll find, as is the case with Luxalon Alu Power. But notice how they simply print 125 to represent 1.25 millimeters. That translation might seem obvious, but I've seen it trip players up in the past, so it's worth noting. For a full table of string gauges, you can check out my guide, which I've linked in the video's description. As you might expect, the gauge or thickness of a string does impact performance. And more often than not, the conversation revolves around durability and spin potential. When comparing different gauges for the same string, the heavier gauge or thicker string will be more durable and long-lasting. That's because when you play tennis, your strings produce friction at the cross sections where they overlap and eventually begin to notch. So as you'd expect, if they're thicker, they'll last longer. Another reason players often consider adjusting the gauge of their string is to enhance spin. Thinner strings increase the potential for spin because they do a better job at gripping or embedding themselves within the ball on contact. With that said, it's worth noting that we're talking relatively subtle changes in spin potential. So if you're looking to produce more topspin, you're not going to notice dramatic changes by opting for a thinner string with a higher gauge. Instead, your grip, technique, and racket head speed will have a more substantial impact, while factors like string gauge, type of string, and racket are secondary for enhancing your ability to generate spin. Another area where you may notice changes using different gauges is with how they feel, as many players report enhanced feel with thinner strings. I happen to love the sensation of a 17-gauge string, but even with a more durable option such as polyester, I tend to break them fairly easily, so 16-gauge is typically the lowest I'll string. If you're new to tennis and you're looking for a recommendation on string gauge, I'd encourage you to start with 16. You'll find a wide selection of strings available at this thickness, but it also happens to be roughly a midway point between other more commonly available gauges, so you'll have room to move up or down based on your experience. For example, Prince Synthetica is a popular and inexpensive string, which you can easily find in 17, 16, and 15 light. Other factors you might consider when picking out a gauge are the type of string in your budget, as well as how often you play and your skill level. For starters, different types of strings offer varying characteristics, such as their level of durability. If you purchase a synthetic gut string, you might opt for a thicker version at a lower gauge because they're not known for their durability. However, if you were to try a polyester, you might experiment with a thinner gauge because they're naturally more durable. When it comes to budget, I typically recommend players string with lower gauges to help increase the life of their strings if they can't afford to restring frequently. As for how often you play, if you're only hitting the court once or twice a month, then durability might not be a huge concern. So you may be more comfortable opting for a thinner gauge if that appeals to you. Last but not least, your skill level can also help point you in the right direction. If you're new to the game, you'll be hard-pressed to tell the difference between different string gauges, so I encourage players to start a bit thicker and then experiment with other gauges as their skills improve. Again, gauge 16 is a great starting point. Ultimately, string gauge is a personal preference developed through trial and error. If you haven't had the opportunity to try different gauges, I'd encourage you to experiment to find out what works best for you. When it comes to string gauge, one of the questions I often get is how players should think about the tension they string their rackets, or more specifically, how tension should be modified when moving up or down a gauge within the same string. Unfortunately, there isn't a clear-cut answer to this question based on how different strings respond to tension at higher and lower gauges. With that said, my recommendation is to think about tension independent of gauge, and to start at the same tension after switching from one gauge to another and to adjust from there. Tension is a big topic on its own, so if you'd like to learn more, be sure to check out my resource on the topic, which I've linked in the description. If you'd like to dive deeper on the topic of string gauge, I'd encourage you to check out my article, which also includes gauges used by top pros. I've linked it in the description as well. If you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate it if you give me a thumbs up. Of course, if you have any questions, feel free to comment below. And if you'd like to join me for future videos, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.